Definitely just vote.
It started. I'm doing it right now.
Yeah.
grateful to have each of you here to support Peter and Brianna, to be here for Oliver. We'd grateful for that support. This is an important part of that. And we'll begin the service with an opening prayer by Brother Jeffrey Rushton.
Our dear Father in heaven, we gather today in grief and love, but we want to express our gratitude to thee for thy gospel and for the promise of eternal life. We wish we could have known Oliver, but we are grateful for thy plan and for the promises that have been made, that we will be family forever. Please bless us today that we can understand, and that we can spend time as family, and that we can enjoy each other's love. And please especially bless Peter and Aubriana, that they can move through their grief, and that they can know that we love them and that you love them. And we ask this in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen.
Thank you, Brother Rushton. I failed to introduce myself. I'm Bishop Dan Reading. Bishop of the ward where Peter and Aubriana have been for the last year and a half now. We're so grateful to have them there. I'm grateful that they have asked me to be a part of this. This is truly a special occasion. I'm just going to make a few comments, keep them brief, and then we're going to do our dedicatory prayer, after which we'll then invite you if you want to come up and see the casket, or to just take a moment yourself that you can do so. But we'll also, at that point, turn the time over back to the funeral director. Thought a lot about what to say. It's kind of a humbling thing to be asked to speak at an event like this. And no words I could say are adequate to express my love, my condolences to you in this time of your suffering. What I do know that is adequate and is sufficient is the Lord's plan and that atonement that has been made. Our loving Heavenly Father gave us a plan. We know that is the plan of salvation. Right? And this is a plan of happiness. A plan that He put forth so that each of us would have these opportunities to experience joy, to experience sorrow, to understand what pain meant, so that we could truly enjoy and cherish the good. I admit, I know the plan from what I've taught as a missionary, from reading about it, scriptures, words of the prophets, both modern and past prophets. But it's times like these that truly help us gain a testimony and understand really what our Heavenly Father meant. And He told us that this would be the happiest time, and that this could be the thing that would make us the happiest. And He's given us this plan. He told us that His plan is to bring past the immortality and eternal life of man. And we know the most important thing to Him is that family, being our Father. Of all the titles He could have chosen, that's the one that He asks us to call Him, because it is that important. And this opportunity, this is something that Heavenly Father knows is the opportunity for you to both counsel together and to counsel with Him, to draw closer to Him and to draw closer as a companionship. I don't understand why He gives us these trials. or why he thinks that sometimes we're strong enough to bear them. But I do know that anyone who ever reaches out to him, who asks him for that help, can find it. And the incredible things, we know that Christ came to this earth and he died for us. Not just for us, he died for every single person that would ever live on this earth. He died for those who would even come and not have that chance to be here on earth, and that we would have that chance to hold them, to see them. And I don't know how, but I absolutely testify to you that through that atonement, families can be together for eternities. That they can absolutely be with each other after we pass through this life. And it doesn't take away the sting of the sorrow. It doesn't take away the sadness or the days, the hard days that you've already experienced or that you will still yet experience. But I promise you this. Anytime you need to feel that comfort from the Lord, that you need to know that he is deeply involved and aware of what you're going through. It doesn't matter where you are. You get down on your knees, you ask the Father for that comfort. And I promise you, he will send it to you. Even in the midst of the deepest suffering and the hardest pain and just the most gut-wrenching sorrow you can feel, you can still feel peace. And that is the beauty of this plan, that he's given us a way to do that. I'll close with just a scripture from a prophet who said, the little children are alive in Christ and have been since the foundation of the world. I hope you can feel the peace of that. Oliver is with his Father in heaven. He is always with you. The sacred covenants that you've made tie you to him and tie him to you completely and for eternity. And I bear that witness of that. And do so in the sacred name of Jesus Christ. Amen. I'll do my best to enunciate for the prayer. Thank you for your reverence. Our Heavenly Father, by the authority of the Melchizedek priesthood, I dedicate and consecrate this burial site, this plot, as the resting place for all of our rest. Pray, Father, and ask that it may be hallowed and protected until the time of the resurrection. Father, we ask thee at this time a blessing of comfort, both Peter and Abriana, as they move forward from this day. We pray, Father, that they might feel thy richest blessings and feel the hope that is alive in this gospel. We pray that they might know and feel a confirming witness of thee that Oliver is with thee and that he loves them. And that even though they do not have the opportunity in this mortality to be with him, that he is with them always. We pray, Father, to feel the confirming witness of thy spirit, the importance and the existence of this plan. We pray that each of us might find opportunity to draw closer to thee, to know thee, and to take this chance to let our sorrow knit our hearts as one, that we can truly mourn together and mourn with those who mourn. And remember those sacred covenants that we have made. Father, we thank thee for the blessings of the temple. We thank thee for the restoration of the gospel, which gives us hope and lets us know that not only can we live with thee again, but that we can live with our families forever and can live with thee and our families in eternity. We thank thee for the comfort we receive from thy holy scriptures, which witness of this plan. We thank thee for the guides that we have, for family, for friends, for those around us who support us. Father, we pray at this time that thou wilt be with Peter and Abriana, that wilt strengthen them, that thou wilt help them grow closer together and learn how they can comfort one another in appropriate ways and in understanding ways, and how they can take this and be an instrument in thy hands for much good. We pray, Father, that we'll witness unto them as well, that they have an eternal family, and that they have so much more waiting for them, and so many great blessings ahead of them. We pray for thy deepest blessings, Father. We pray that we might always keep in our hearts a reminder of the hope and the faith that burns brightly, that we might always retain a testimony of our covenants and our promises that we make to thee. And thou wilt always bless us and strengthen us forever. We ask a sacred blessing on Oliver, to keep and hold him and protect him and watch over him until his parents are again reunited with him and his family is reunited with him. And this we humbly ask in the sacred name of thy Son, our Savior, Jesus the Christ. Amen.
The cemetery won't come over and do the rest of the burial until after everybody has left, but you can come back and visit a couple hours and we should be done. Is there anything else that... Anything?